Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. Today we are going to discuss a problem based on AC circuits from module 3. Let's see the question. A series circuit consists of a resistance of 6 ohm and an inductance reactance of 8 ohm. A potential difference of 141.4 volt RMS value is applied to it. At a certain instant, the applied voltage is plus 100 volt and is increasing. Calculate the following at this condition. That is, first question is current, voltage drop across the resistance and voltage drop across the inductive reactance. Okay, so what about the given data from this question? They have given the value of resistance, which is equal to 6 ohm, and what about the inductive reactance, which is equal to 8 ohm. And a potential difference, applied voltage is 141.4 volt RMS value is the applied voltage. Okay, so that is, here they have given resistance and reactance, means we will represent like an impedance form. In impedance form we will represent like R plus jx, where R is the resistance and x is the reactance. And all these values they have already given. That means 6 plus j 8 ohm, which is in rectangular form, which is in rectangular form. So in order to convert into polar form, this is in polar form. We know all the formulas, we have already discussed in previous lectures. Square root of, if it is a and b, a plus jb, its magnitude is square root of a square plus b square angle tan inverse b by a, and here we are replacing b with 8 and a with 6. Okay, that is, we will get the values 10 angle 53.1, which is in the form mod set angle phi, mod set angle phi. Okay, so this is about resistance and reactance. And what about the potential difference? The applied voltage is given in RMS value. The RMS is equal to 141.4 volt, and we know if we have RMS value, how to calculate the maximum value? V RMS equal to Vm by root 2, that is Vm equal to, Vm is equal to cross multiplication root 2 into VRMS, which is equal to 200 volt. This is the maximum value, Vm equal to 200 volt. And we know usually we are representing any phasor value in the form of sine wave, that is V equal to Vm sin omega t. We can consider either sine or cos according to our convenience, and here I am considering it as sine. So I am considering the applied voltage V as Vm into sin omega t, and we know what is the value of Vm, 200 sin omega t. 200 sin omega t is our applied voltage. Okay, and what we need to calculate? Current, voltage drop across resistance and reactance. So for that we need to calculate what will be the general form for current I. What will be the value for current? V divided by impedance, voltage divided by impedance. So Vm sin omega t divided by, what is the value of our impedance? We know for division and multiplication we will consider the polar form of impedance. So here the polar form is nothing but mod set angle phi, that is Vm divided by mod set sin omega t minus phi. Okay, this angle phi will go to the numerator, that means it will comes like omega t minus phi. This is the general form of current equation, general form of current equation, and we already know the values for Vm, mod set and phi. Okay, that is 200 divided by 10 sin omega t minus 1 degree. So the equation for current is 200 divided by 10 sin omega t minus, sorry, it's not 1, 53.1 degree, that is equal to 20 sine omega t minus 53.1 degree. But in the question, they have asked for the current and voltage values if the applied voltage is 100 volt. If the applied voltage is 100 volt. So in the general equation, if we submit the voltage value as 100, let's find the value for omega t. So that is 100 volt equal to 200 sine omega t, 200 sine omega t, from which we will get sine omega t is equal to 100 divided by 200, or we can say 1 by 2. That means omega t is equal to 30 degree. If the applied voltage is plus 100 volt, the value of omega t is equal to 30 degree. So if we know the value of omega t, we can substitute over here and we'll get the value for current if the applied voltage is 100 volt. That is, I is equal to current, I is equal to I of 30 degree is equal to 20 sine 30 minus 53.1 degree minus 7.847 amperes. This is the value of current I when the applied voltage is plus 100 volt. Then next we need to find the voltage drop across the resistance. We know the value for voltage drop across the resistance is equal to V is equal to I into R, and we know the value for current I is equal to minus 7.847 multiplied by the value of resistance R is equal to 6, which is equal to 47.08 volt. Okay, now what about the value for voltage drop across the inductive reactance? In case of calculating voltage drop across resistance, there we don't require any conceptual approach and all. But in case of inductive reactance, we need to consider the phasor diagram for better understanding. In this phasor diagram, this red line indicates our general equation for applied voltage, that is Vm sin omega t. Here we no need to consider any phase angle or something, because here omega t plus or minus 0 degree. 0 degree means it's in line. Okay. So we know the value for our I is Im. Instead of Vm by mod Z, I am considering the value as Im, or we can replace it like Vm by mod Z. Okay, we know the value for I is Vm by mod Z sin omega t minus phi. We know minus means clockwise direction. Clockwise direction means 53.1 degree. The value of our phi is 53.1 degree in clockwise direction. That is, negative means lagging current. The current is lagging the voltage by an angle of 53.1 degree. But we know for an inductor, the voltage leads current by an angle of 90 degree. Voltage leads current by an angle of 90 degree. That means this angle will be 90 minus 53.1, which is equal to 36.9 degree. So if we consider a general equation for our voltage drop across inductive reactance, we can write the maximum voltage Im multiplied by inductive reactance X, inductive reactance X multiplied by sine omega t. I am considering this as our reference line, sine omega t plus 36.9 degree. Why it is plus? Because with reference to our applied voltage, this voltage is leading. Leading means plus 36.9 degree, and we know the values for Im, XL and omega t if the applied voltage is plus 100 volt. That is, what is the value of Im? 20. 20 multiplied by what is XL? 8 multiplied by sin omega t value is 30 plus 36.9, which is equal to 147.17 volt. This is the value of voltage drop across the inductive reactance. In case of resistance, we no need to consider any phasor diagram or something. Why? Because resistance, the voltage drop across the resistance and the current are in phase. In phase means 0 degree phase difference. So no need to consider any phasor diagram. Okay, so I think this question is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please feel free to comment in the comment section. So we will see within another lecture in the next video. Thank you.